Hi everyone, WifeyWubs here. Are you interested in VTubing but not really sure where to start? In today's tutorial, I'll be going over the basics of setting up your model in Vtube Studio. Our first step will be to make sure your model's folder with all of its assets has been put into the Live2D folder, which you can find by following this file path. Now you can open up Vtube Studio. Double-click to open the menu if it's minimized, click the model icon here in the top left, and select your model from the list provided. This will also include models that are already installed in Vtube Studio that you can play around with if you haven't got a model ready to go. Once your model has loaded in, you'll need to start the fine-tuning process that will work best for your setup. To do this, click the pink cogwheel on the left menu, the camera icon in the top left corner, and this will open the settings for tracking your model. You'll need to select which camera you want to use to capture your face from the menu here, followed by the resolution, FPS, and color format. The options you're given will depend on what hardware you're using. After this, you'll need to pick a tracking quality setting. At the time of this recording, Vtube Studio now offers RTX On for NVIDIA Broadcast Tracker, as well as Google's MediaPipe Webcam Tracker, in addition to levels 0 through 5. For my setup, level 5 seems to work the best. Now you can press Camera On, which will bring up a window that shows the tracking map of your face. You can press Calibrate if your webcam sits higher than face level, so your model's default position will be where you want it. Next, we'll take a look at the Tracking Settings menu. Here, you can fine-tune the sensitivity parameters to better match your facial movements. Play around with the sliders until your model's movements feel natural to you. If you have a Tobii eye tracker, you can also enable it here and decide what it's allowed to overwrite. I prefer for my webcam to track my head and body movements, but for my Tobii to track my eyes for better accuracy. It's important to remember that if you are using Tobii, you must open the Tobii Experience application, followed by Vtube Studio, and then your broadcasting software, or you will receive this error. As for the rest of these settings, they're a bit more in depth, so we'll leave them at their default settings for now. In the next tab here, you'll be able to adjust a plethora of your model's movement and physics settings, but for right now, we will only look at the movement config setting. If you don't want your model to move around on the screen every time your head or body moves, simply toggle this setting off. This allows the motion of head and body turns without your model zooming in, out, and moving all around the screen when you move. For our next video, we'll cover how to capture Vtube Studio in OBS, how to use and place items, and some of the ins and outs of hotkeys. Thank you so much for watching! Please consider leaving a like and comment if you found this tutorial to be helpful, and subscribe for more of my future content. Have a great day!